From the Sanctuary at 7th and Broadway in Nashville, Tennessee, the Music Ministry of First Baptist Nashville presents How Can I Keep From Singing? A worship experience by the youth choir, handbells, and sanctuary orchestra.
Thank you for tonight. Thank you for being here with us. We welcome you here. I thank you for this room where generations of voices have sung praises to you. And thank you for our students who add their songs to that history tonight. God, only you are worthy for us to sing these songs to. Only you are worthy of our praise. And we offer that to you tonight. We ask you to stay here with us and to be with our students tonight as they minister to us. We love you, Lord. Amen.
It's a joy to welcome each of you tonight to the worship of God at First Baptist Church Nashville. And I know that you're proud of our students. It's always great to see parents and grandparents here, but it's always a special joy to see folks that may not have young people in this choir that are your children. But you're here because you love them and you love the work and you support the work of our church. And we're just very, very thankful that you're here. If First Baptist is not your home and you're joining us tonight, we'd love to get to know you. And so take a moment before the service is over or when the service is over, I should say, and give us a chance to say hello. And we don't have visitor's cards or anything like that tonight, but we are glad that you're here and hope that you're blessed by this time together. Joe Fitzpatrick is our worship and music pastor at First Baptist Church, and he leads our choir. And we're very, very thankful for his 5 years of leadership with us. Joe, blessings on you as you continue to lead our choir tonight.
Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. We want to join in singing together, lifting our voices in praise to our King. Would you stand with me as we sing together hymn number 322? Number 322, How Great is Our God.
And all the earth rejoice, and all the earth rejoice.
people said, amen. God bless you. You may be seated.
As you come to him, the living stone, rejected by humans but chosen by God and precious to him, you also, like living stones, are being built into a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, offering spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For in Scripture it says, "See, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame. Now to you who believe, this stone is precious, but to those who do not believe, the stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone."
Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Isaiah 55:12. You will go out in joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and the hills will burst into song before you, and the trees on the field will clap their hands.
with Sandy. Psalm 47, 1 through 7. Clap your hands, all you nations. Shout to God with cries of joy. For the Lord Most High is awesome, the great King over all the earth. He subdued nations under us, peoples under our feet. He chose our inheritance for us, the pride of Jacob, whom he loved. God has ascended amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid the sounding of trumpets. Sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our King, sing praises. For God is the King of all the earth, sing to him a song of praise.
As for God, his way is perfect. The Lord's word is flawless. He shields all who take refuge in him. For who is God besides the Lord? And who is the rock except our God? It is God who arms me with strength and keeps my way secure. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer. He causes me to stand on the heights. Psalm 27, 4 through 5. One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I might dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his sacred tent and set my feet upon a rock.
On the upward way, new heights I gain.
Lord, have mercy on my brother. Lord, have mercy on my sister. And while I'm praying down on my knees,
Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on my brother.
Have mercy, O
Lord. Have mercy on my sister.
Have mercy, and
while I'm praying down on my knees, Lord, have mercy on me.
Who's lying on a bed of pain? We're praying, Lord, won't you lift him up and take his burden away?
Lord, have mercy on my brother.
Have mercy, O
Lord. Have mercy on my sister.
Have mercy, and
while I'm praying down on my knees, Lord, have mercy on me.
For the children caring for the parents, for the mother worrying about her child,
praying,
Lord, won't you lift him up and give them peace for a while.
Psalms 4, 6, and 7. When Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have light of life.
Thank you.
of mercy, breath of God, life from life sustaining us, earth below and skies above, beautiful redemption song.
Melodies like morning rise, darkness leaning toward the dawn. Into our sorrow sings the light, a beautiful redemption song.
Come and see, empty grave and lifted stone,
sinners saved and captives free,
beautiful redemption song.
Once God
Tonight we've been blessed, haven't we? I know you are so proud of these young people. This is a busy, busy time of year. It's a time of transition, final exams, the end of a school year. What you see tonight is the product of a lot of hard work that's taken place this entire school year. And as we know, they're about to embark on a very, very busy summer. There'll be a mission tour, choir tour, to San Antonio, Texas. That's taking place in June. That'll be followed by a youth camp experience. That'll be followed by a trip for our seniors to go to Haiti. There's just a very, very busy, busy time. And as you know, the summers get shorter and shorter and shorter. And we're so blessed to be able to be a part of this church family with great young people. And we appreciate so much the job they've done. Would you express yourself to them tonight? Let them know how much you appreciate them. Very proud of their work, and we're very proud of Joe and the team that Joe has assembled to help do something like this. This doesn't happen without an awful lot of work, as you know, each year. And so, Joe, thank you to you and to your staff and everyone.
We do appreciate your prayers, your support, and encouragement, and for your presence as we sought to worship the Lord Jesus Christ together here tonight. As we prepare to go on mission for God in San Antonio, Texas, and stopping off in the Dallas-Fort Worth area as well, we do appreciate, once again, your prayers, your support, your participation in the Winter Gala experience, and all the things you've done to encourage these young people in their walk with Jesus Christ. We close tonight's program with, "How Can I Keep From Singing?" And may we all have that sense as we have the song of Christ. Jesus is the song. We have Him living in us. That we will be bold about sharing and proclaiming the good news of Christ through joyful songs of praise, through words of encouragement to others, and proclaim that He is King of Kings and Lord of Lords.